Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel. The old audience know that we have torn down lots of wireless chargers and wall chargers. And today we found a very special charger which integrates wireless and wall chargers. That's the 5-in-1 GaN wireless fast charger from Fledging Spruce. We can see it consists of a powerful charger base and a wireless charging pad. And we can also transfer it into a charging stand just like this. The overall size is relatively big, so it should be placed on your desktop at home or office. After folding, the charging pad is like a square. And this time we got the white version, it also has black and gray. The shelf still adopts flame retardant PC, and the front charging pad is transparent acrylic, accidentally broken. And the brand logo is in the middle. The input port is on the back. There are 3 USB-C ports and 1 USB-A port at the bottom. The single USB-C can support up to 100 watts. Single USB-A can support up to 36 watts. The total power can reach 132 watts. The wireless charging pad can support up to 10 watts. There is an LED indicator here. Another one is on the other side. The specifications are printed here. Product name is Desktop Charger. Model is SPR140. It supports input of 100 to 240 volts, 50 or 60 Hz, 2.5 amp. You can use it globally. C1, C2, C3 can support 100 watts max, USB-A can support 36 watts max. For the rest of the information, I'll put it in here, you can pause to see it. It has passed the PSE, CE, FCC, ETL, ROSE and other certifications. As for the actual size, the length is 109mm, the width is 79mm, the thickness is 47.2mm, weight is about 474 grams. When power is on, the indicator light will turn blue. Use such a LED power ZKT002 to test. USB-C 1 supports Apple 2.4A, Samsung 5V 2A, DCB Portugal, and QC2, QC3, AFC, FCP, SCP, PE2, PD3, PPS fast charging portables. It also supports 5 fixed PDOs of 9V, 3A, 12V, 3A, 15V, 3A, 20V, 5A, and 1 PPS PDOs of 3.3 to 11V, 3A. The portable of C2 is the same as C1, as well as the PDO. As for the C3 port, exactly the same. USB-A supports QC3, QC2, AFC, FCP, SCP, PE2 fast charging portable. The bottom will form a groove after opening the charging pad. Those holes on the back are used to dissipate heat. You can choose your own way to charge your phone, no matter horizontal or vertical. Then let's check the compatibility of this charger. When charging MacBook Pro 16-inch, the power is 89 watts. When charging iPhone 12 Pro Max, the power is 23 watts. When charging Mi 11, the power is 28 watts. When charging Samsung S21, the power is 21 watts. When charging Oppo Reno 6 Pro, the power is 17 watts. When charging OnePlus 9 Pro, the power is 17 watts. When 4 ports are connected to the device at the same time, the USB-C one can still reach 83 watts. And the wireless charging part can work properly. Okay, that will be the brief introduction of this product. Then let's open it to see what's inside. Remove the shell and we can see the internal PCB is attached with a thermal pad. Remove the black isolation board of bottom shell, we can see the metal heatsink. And of course, another heatsink is covered on the PCB, and it also exists on the top of the case to help dissipate heat. There are inductors, capacitors, and transformer on the front PCB. This charger adopts the architecture of PFC and LLC switching power supply. The output has secondary step-down circuit. The front side can be divided into 4 parts. The input side is responsible for EMI filtering and rectification. The middle is responsible for PFC boosting and filtering. The left side is LLC circuit. Those 4 small boards are secondary step-down circuits. PFC boost and LLC control circuit are on the back. This is the main controller, 3 GaN power transistors, and a silicon carbide diode. Here is also a synchronous rectifier controller. Here is a 5A time delay fuse. The surge suppressor resistor is next to it. This is a varistor. The yellow one is a safety capacitor. 2 common mode chokes are in here. And the rectifier bridge is vertical to save space. Here are 2 CBB capacitors and 1 inductor for filtering. The middle one is the boost inductor. here are 7 electrolytic capacitors in parallel used to filtering after boost. The total capacity is 106 microfarad. The LLC circuit contains the transformer, LLC inductor, and LLC resonant capacitor. The master control chip comes from NXP TEA2016AAT. It integrates LLC controller, PFC controller, and multiple protection functions, which can simplify the design and reduce components. The PFC boost switch transistor is in here, which comes from Innoscience INN650D02. Specification is 650 volts 0.2 ohm. And the Maplesemi silicon carbide diode is next to it, packaged by DFN5×6. It is suitable for high power density GaN chargers. Those two are also Innoscience power transistors, which can form LLC half bridge and are controlled by the master control chip to step down. Here is the CT1019 optocoupler used to regulate voltage. The synchronous rectifier controller comes from NXP TEA2095. The corresponding position on the back is 2 synchronous rectifier MOSFETs. Specifications of those two red filter capacitors are 25 volts, 680 microfarad. We found the step-down circuit of 3 USB-C are identical. A step-down chip and 2 step-down MOSFETs are on the front. The step-down inductor and output filter capacitor are on the back. This is a highly integrated dual-port Ismartware particle chip with multiple fast-charging particles, model is SW3518S. It has passed Volk certification and the maximum output power is 100 watts. The 2 step-down MOSFETs and a V-bus switch MOSFET come from a Maplesemi. The specification of output filter capacitor on the back is 25 volts, 220 microfarad. The single-chip microcomputer is used for intelligent power distribution. There is also a step-down circuit on the small PCB of USB-A. This is the high-efficiency synchronous buck converter. It supports input of 7 to 38 volts and the output can be up to 6 amp. Next, let's tear down the wireless charging pad. This part consists of PCB and double coils. This master control chip of wireless charging comes from injoinic IP6809, which is also the world's first wireless charging chip that supports QC3 input certification. It supports 2 to 3 coils and output of 5 to 15 volts. There are 2 drive MOSFETs of coil. Those two are switching MOSFETs of coil. All of them come from AGM Semi. Well, that's all components of this Fledging Spruce 5-in-1 GaN wireless fast charger. As a desktop charging station, this product can perfectly charge mobile phones, tablets, TWS headphones, and laptops through 4 physical fast charging ports and a wireless charging pad. It also has good protocol compatibility and output strategy of multi-port, which can greatly improve the user experience. But the disadvantage is obvious, too big and a little bit expensive. The current price is $89.99 on their official website. Feel free to click the link in the description to take a look. Okay, that's all for today's video. Hope you'll like it. And if you think this video is helpful, you can click the subscribe button for future updates. See you in the next video. Bye!